the mainstream media did this.
Mr. Reagan.
The mainstream media has been stoking resentment against white people and against American culture for a few decades now. It has worked in parallel with academia, both in the K through 12 public school system and in the halls of so-called higher learning. These institutions have been teaching white people that racism is bad, that you should love and respect everyone no matter their race. And that to hate someone merely because of the color of their skin, well, that's just wrong. It's pure evil. And so they should have done. I think that kind of message is right. I think that racism is not only wrong, but it's illogical. It harms both the victim of the racism and the racist and society as a whole. And you know they've been teaching us this. Most of you watching this, you were there. You probably didn't go to any of the schools that I went to, but you probably had the same experience. But here's the problem. This has exclusively been taught in the white schools. While they were teaching us to love and not to hate, they were also teaching us that white colonists exploited natives, and white settlers stole this land, and white farmers enslaved, raped, and beat black slaves, sometimes to death. We've been taught for decades that the white man is evil, and that the black man is the innocent victim. We've been taught that California is really part of Mexico and that we just stole it. We've been taught that oil and diamonds and gold and every other natural resource ever pulled out of the ground was stolen from native populations and extracted through the forced labor of various non-white peoples of the good earth. The message was simple. Dark people good, white people bad. Never mind that there were lots of really good white people throughout history. Most white people, in fact, were very good, God-fearing Christians for the past few hundred years. Never mind that. That's not what they want us to believe. Why? Well, we'll get to that in a minute. Right now, I want to talk about the black schools and the Hispanic schools. You see, teaching black people not to be racist didn't occur to leftist educators. To them, well, the black people, they were the victims. Why would they ever be racist? So they didn't get the anti-racist message. They just got the white people are bad message. And this is the result, ladies and gentlemen. The race riots that you are now seeing, this is the result of an education system and a leftist media that has brainwashed generations of Americans into believing that white people are bad. Republicans are racist. Republicans run the system, and the system is engineered to oppress the darker-skinned population. It's an insidious lie. Rioting was not the intention of these people. The burning of businesses and the cars and the looting, these were not the intention. It's the intention of other sinister people, but that's a whole other video. Actually, if you want to know about that stuff, read this book by Sebastian Gorka, The War for America's Soul. Excellent, excellent book. Sebastian Gorka actually sent it to me specifically because I asked him about why he thinks that the mainstream media buys into all this crap, but amazing, amazing book. Great read. I highly recommend it. Right now, I want to focus on the racial aspect because America was moving away from racism. Up until about the 1980s, America was moving away from racism. But then Americans were pushed back into a state of racism. Again, it wasn't intentional, at least not at first, but it was a very effective propaganda campaign. It turned America into one of the most racist places in the world in 2020, if you can believe it. But not against blacks, not against Mexicans, not against people of color, not against the people that were told America is racist against. No, America is racist against white people. Now, I really do not want to put an ad in this video because I think this video is too important. I don't like putting ads in really important videos. But this is actually one of the things that's under attack in these riots, capitalism. And so as a point of principle, I am going to try to sell you something. With the majority of the world's workforce now working from home, VPN security is now preferred. Cyber spying is at an all-time high, and a useful tool you can use to protect yourself is a VPN or a virtual private network to scramble your computer's identity from nosy cyber criminals. Here, let me show you how easy it is to protect yourself. I'm gonna go to virtualshield.com and I'm gonna download the Virtual Shield free 30-day trial. Install it and click connect. Once you're connected, the IP address is now different than before. Virtual Shield is the easiest to use. It's got the fastest server connections and offers a money-back guarantee. Due to the recent pandemic of COVID-19, Virtual Shield wants to offer 50% off all VPN plans and all premium add-ons, including Protection Plus, Residential Access, and VIP Performance plans for as low as a cup of coffee. Sign up for a free 30-day trial to Virtual Shield VPN and see what all the hype is about. You have nothing to lose. After the schools told all the little black and Mexican boys and girls in America that evil, rich, white Republicans hate them and want to oppress them, CNN and MSNBC and the New York Times and BuzzFeed and the Washington Post and PBS and NPR and Politico and Huffington Post and all these leftist media outlets, they came along and they started brainwashing these Americans in even more sophisticated ways. Now let's talk about why. It starts with two groups. The first group is the neo-Marxists, but that's a bit complicated, and I want to keep this video simple, so let's stick with the second group. The second group is Democrat politicians. Now, why would Democrat politicians want darker-skinned Americans to be racist of white Americans? Votes. The Democrat voting bloc is actually a patchwork quilt of special interest groups. It's hard for conservatives to appreciate this sometimes because we don't work in that way. The conservative political philosophy is based on a system of ethical principles, and conservative voters are all unified by these basic principles. We're a unified voting bloc that works together. We have smaller fringe groups that tend to vote with us, but for the most part, we all hold traditional Christian values. That tends to be the fundamental set of principles by which our political philosophy is guided. Democrats don't have that. What they have are groups. The primary groups are feminists, blacks, environmentalists, Hispanics, especially Hispanic immigrants, gays, lesbians, bisexuals, academics, and of course, beta males. I'm joking about the beta males, of course. They're just the little bitches that go along with whatever the other groups tell them. But the rest of these groups are special interest groups in the purest sense of the term. They are groups of people who have very special desires. All these groups want either money or power or both. And in order to get their votes, Democrats have been offering them money and power for decades. Do you think that the hardcore environmentalists really care about the cause of feminism? Maybe there's a bit of a crossover, but no, not really. Do you think that blacks care at all about the gays? Most of them are homophobic, for crying out loud. They don't care one bit. None of these groups really cares about the other groups. Not really. But they pretend to care because they're all in a loose contract with each other. They all vote for Democrat politicians, and the Democrat politicians send a bit of money or power their way or develop legislation that will in some way be favorable to these groups. It's basically a way of paying for votes. And this has become so critical to Democrat power that they are utterly dependent on it. But again, why is it in the best interest of Democrat politicians to make darker pigmented Americans racist against white Americans? Well, it's because contrary to popular belief, Republicans actually care about black people. We care about Mexicans. We care about gays and women and the environment and science and education. We actually do care about all of these people and all of these things. And that's a problem for the left, because if Democrat voters in this patchwork of special interest groups, they think about that too much, they might be persuaded by conservative ideas. They might gasp, even become Republican. You see, the Democrats over the decades have worked under a motive to get votes, while Republicans have worked under a motive of maintaining the integrity of the principles that undergird the conservative political philosophy. And by maintaining the integrity of our principles, we were guided not toward the most efficient way to collect votes, but to actually solve problems that plague the country. And so now we have two parties with very clear platforms. The Democrat platform is pandering to special interests. The Republican platform is improving the country. Now, this is a losing prospect for Democrats. So what can Democrats do? Well, if they can maintain the perception that they've infected their constituents with, the perception that only Democrats have their interest at heart and Republicans are working against them, well, then they can probably keep those voters. But there's a huge problem. It's not true. They don't actually have the best interest of their voters at heart. They just want their votes. And what's worse, Republicans actually do have their best interest at heart. We want black Americans to prosper. We want the environment to stay healthy. We want every American to be free to pursue happiness. We actually really truly believe in those things. So how do the politicians keep their voters from realizing this? Fear and anger. Fear and anger are emotions, and emotions curtail rational thought. If they can keep environmentalists and gays and blacks scared or angry, then these voters, when considering political issues, they will perpetually be too emotional to think. This is the same reason CNN and MSNBC and the other leftist media outlets tell their viewers not to watch Fox, not to read Breitbart. They tell them, these conservatives are conspiracy theorists, they're evil. They will trick you into believing their evil lies. And it's the same reason that they censor this channel. They shadow ban me and other conservative YouTubers. Now, we on the right, we say just the opposite. We say read the New York Times, watch CNN, expose yourself to leftist ideas. You see, we on the right, we propose that the left has bad ideas. The left proposes that the right are evil people. And if you can convince your voters that your opponent is literally evil, then those voters won't even listen to your opponent because those voters will not want to be tricked by their evilness. The media goes along with this because they're true believers. They've imbibed the Kool-Aid. And now we've come to the culmination of all of their efforts. These race riots are not merely the random expression of a frustrated populace naturally enraged by marginalization and oppression as CNN and MSNBC is currently reporting. These race riots, they're the effect of decades of brainwashing by the media and by academia. The mainstream media did this. If you tell a group of people that another group of people is evil and that they're their enemy, eventually you will convince that group of this. And that's what they've done. Originally, they did this for the votes, but they inadvertently pushed too hard. Their propaganda was too effective. And now thousands of people all over the country are looting stores, burning buildings, and causing as much havoc and mayhem as possible. And it's not because of George Floyd. If you ask most of the people rioting, they won't know the man's name. Some of them probably won't even know what happened in Minneapolis. Most of these people are rioting purely for the fun of it, purely out of hatred. These are hateful people, and their hate has been sparked, stoked, and fueled by academia and mainstream media. They are directly responsible for the attitudes of these rioters. The rioters themselves are, of course, responsible for their own detestable actions. I watched a group of rioters beat a man to death in Dallas tonight. My friend Elijah recorded it. It was one of the most grotesque things I've ever seen ever in my life. These people are monsters. And as I said, they are responsible for their own detestable actions. Totally and completely. Those people all need to go to prison for the rest of their lives. But the media and academia, they are responsible for the twisted hatred that was planted in their hearts. These people are no longer thinking citizens. They're emotional racists. There is little hope that they will ever be pacified. Leftist politicians are calling for the heads of the police officers involved. They think that mob justice will placate the rioters. It won't. These people don't care about the death of George Floyd or the cop who killed him. They've been taught their entire lives that any shortcoming in their life, any failure, is the fault of evil, rich, white Republicans. And they're taught that these evil, rich, white Republicans, they own all the businesses. And so if they destroy the businesses, well, then they're hurting the evil, rich, white men who have been oppressing them their whole lives. They believe they're striking back at those who have been the cause of all their failures. These people are living in a fantasy that has been fed to them by academia and the mainstream media their whole lives. You did this, mainstream media. You did this. And as always, it's not that our liberal friends are ignorant. It's just that they know so much. That isn't so. Good night.
The goal for all of us should be that one day things will be done neither because of nor in spite of any of the differences between us, ethnic differences or racial differences, whatever they may be, that we will have total equal opportunity for all people. And I would do everything I could in my power to bring that about.